Hi and welcome to my channel. Today I'm going to show you how to achieve this makeup look. Glowy, fresh and juicy, perfect for summer days. I'm going to use some of my favorite products and I'm going to show you some of the products that I use for my skin type, which is acne prone skin. I'm going to show you the SPF that I use, the foundation and also the powder. These three are really good for acne prone skin. I already prepped my skin and for that I used this SPF from Bioderma, which is absolutely my favorite. It gives you the most beautiful glow. Now I'm going to apply on the highest points of my face this Strobe Cream from MAC in the shade Goldlite, and for that I'm going to use my foundation brush, which is the F80 from Sigma. A small amount on the back of my hand and then I'm going to apply on the highest points of my face. Also, I already did my eyebrows, and if you want to see how I do my eyebrows, let me know in the comments down below. If I want more coverage, then I will spot conceal before I apply my foundation, but for a everyday makeup look, it doesn't bother me. I like to see texture, I like to see how the skin is. Even if I have some spots, I really don't care about that. I'm going to mix Armani Luminous Silk, shade 6, and the Beauty Blender Bounce Foundation 2.40, and the same brush. Don't forget your neck, always, always, because we don't want a line here. And now I'm taking a sponge, this is the e.l.f. one. I'm just going to tap, but really, really, really soft and gentle. For my concealer, Nars Radiant Creamy Concealer, custard and vanilla. These two are my personal concealers, so I'm going to apply straight on my face. But if you are a makeup artist or if you do makeup for someone else, don't apply straight on your client's face. Apply first on the back of your hand or use something like this. So first, custard only on the inner corner and on the outer corner for some lift. Now vanilla, because it's a little lighter. Try to be really, really, really gentle under your eyes and on the mobile lid also. There is something with this concealer. It doesn't become cakey. You don't feel like you have concealer under your eyes. For my cream contour, I'm going to use the Patrick Ta one in the shade She's Sculpted, and I'm going to apply it with the 168 from MAC, like this. See, it's so, so beautiful. And the trick is to be really, really gentle in order not to move your foundation. And for some lift, I'm going to apply it here and drag it to the temple. I'm going to set everything. RCMA No-color powder. This one is 90% like the Laura Mercier one. I really like that one also, but for today I'm going to use the RCMA one. And for my face, I'm going to apply it with 135 from MAC. Tap, tap, tap. If you want your contour to look more seamless and to be more beautiful and blended really well, try to apply first powder, because dry surface on a dry surface slips better. I'm going to blend everything here. Okay, now let's warm up the skin. Hoola from Benefit. This is my all-time favorite bronzer, because it's not too warm, it's not too cool, and the shade, it's perfect for so, so many skin tones. It's really, really good. And I'm going to apply it with the 127 from Zoeva. I'm going to give myself a little lift here. I'm going to mix Hoola with this one from Patrick Ta, and I'm going to apply under my eyes. This trick is good if your under eyes crease a lot, because this is going to hide the fact that your eyes under eyes crease and you are not going to see those creases. Okay. And this makes the eyes a lot bigger. Same shades for my crease also. 776 blending brush from Bdellium. And because we applied the bronzer here also, everything is going to look more more seamless, and you are not going to see where your eyeshadow starts and where it ends. For my blush, I'm going to use today the Patrick Ta one. Oh, she's different. You need only a small amount because they are so pigmented. Like the first time when I tried them, I was shocked. I was like, it's impossible for a blush to be so pigmented. So be very, very careful. But the texture of the blush is really soft. Look how pigmented it is. It's insane. Like I can't believe it even now. If you want more lifting effect, try to apply higher the blush. I like to apply it here also and on my eyes. And now I'm going to take the cream blush and I'm going to apply it over the powder. And this is going to give you the most beautiful flushed cheeks, and everything is going to look more glowy and not so powdery. For my cream highlighter, BECCA Shimmering Skin Perfector Liquid shade Moonstone. The shade is perfect for so many skin tones, but unfortunately BECCA went bankrupt, and I don't know if you are going to find this one, but I also like the Hollywood Flawless Filter from Charlotte Tilbury. I like the shade 4 and 3, but today I'm going to use this one from BECCA. I'm going to take just a small amount on the back of my hand and I'm going to apply it with the beauty sponge on the highest points of my face, and you will see what a beautiful glow this product gives to the skin. Like, look at this glow. Like, it looks so healthy. The skin looks so healthy. For my highlighter, Mary-Lou from the Balm with the brush 133 from MAC. Tap first, tap, 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 and then blend it on the brow bone, on the highest points of my face, on the cupid's bow. For my eyes, I'm going to apply Caviar Eye Stick shade Metallic Taupe from Laura Mercier. This type of cream eyeshadow doesn't need to be set with a powder eyeshadow. And I'm going to apply it on my lid. And I'm going to, where is my brush? Here. I'm going to blend it with the same brush that I used for my crease. For the inner corner of the eyes, this eyeliner from e.l.f. It's the H2O proof eyeliner pen. This is so intense, like the black is so intense. Look straight, and I'm going to follow my natural line. Now I take the powder off. And now I'm using some Hoola and then some blush. Now some highlighter like straight here and on the bridge of the nose, like this. For mascara, I'm going to mix two from Benefit, the Bad Girl and the They Are Real Magnet Mascara. For my lips today, I'm going to mix two lip pencils from NYX, Nude Beige and Nude Truffle. Look at this one. How tiny is this one? I really like this shade, Nude Beige. First Nude Beige and then Nude Truffle. And I'm going to lift my lips a little by applying some concealer here. We finally are able to go outside without wearing a mask. We can apply lip gloss on our lips. Fenty shade, Fenty Glow. This is my all-time favorite. It's almost empty. And I really love this combo, the Nude Beige and Nude Truffle from NYX and this one from Fenty. Perfect for summer. And this is the final look, super glowy, juicy, fresh, perfect for summer days. In my opinion, this makeup is really good for any type of event, even for a bride. If you want to spice it a little bit, you can apply some red lipstick and you will be fabulous. I hope you enjoyed today's makeup look. Let me know what you think about this makeup in the comments down below. If you liked this video, please give it a thumbs up, subscribe to my channel, also follow me on Instagram and TikTok. I post a lot of makeup tutorials. Thank you so much for watching and see you on my next video. Bisous!